Hello and welcome to Tea Leaves Programming. Today we're counting like it's 1479. Living, as I do, at the precise intersection of nerdy computer stuff and financial accounting, I knew it was only a matter of time before someone asked me about plain text accounting. This is a bit of a fad among the Hacker News set. I've kind of held off talking about it for a while because my feelings on it are fairly nuanced, and as we all know, talking about nuance on the internet is hopeless. But my viewers are generally smarter, more beautiful, and just generally better people than average, so I'm going to give it a shot. In this video, I'm going to talk about what plain text accounting is, give a few examples of plain text accounting software in action, talk about what's good about it, and also talk about what's bad about it, and then wrap up by explaining why it's not really the right tool for me, even if it might be the perfect tool for you. I dipped into these plain text systems in the beginning of 2020 when I was on a kick to try every possible accounting system that existed on the Mac. Look, you get bored during quarantine, what can I say? I spent about 5 months maintaining my plain text books in the package called beancount alongside my existing accounting system. I found it sort of fun, definitely a neat hack, but ended up setting it aside because from the perspective of my personal finances, it was optimized to solve the wrong problems. But I don't regret experimenting with it at all. Let me describe exactly what we're talking about. Plain text accounting is a way of doing bookkeeping using plain text files and command line friendly software. In fact, I prefer to call it plain text bookkeeping. The underlying philosophical belief is the idea that using sophisticated bookkeeping tools and proprietary database formats makes your financial data harder to access. The claim of plain text accounting enthusiasts is that this type of ledger is more future-proof, it's easier to integrate with other tools, and it's simpler for the user to understand. There are a number of plain text bookkeeping systems in common use. By far, the three most common are Ledger, hledger, and beancount. Here's an example of a beancount ledger I made for an intro video a while ago. And it sure does look pretty simple. Adding data to my general ledger is as simple as typing a new line. So we can see that keeping track of your transactions is really as simple as typing in some formatted plain text whenever you spend, receive, or transfer money. But how do you get information out of the ledger? Do you just read it? No. Each of these systems comes with the ability to very quickly and easily query the ledger and generate financial reports. For example, in beancount, if I want to generate a balance sheet summarizing my current financial position, I'd go to the command line and type bean-report, the name of my file, and balsheet. You can also easily make more specific queries as well if I want to know how much I spent on groceries or to display a list of those transactions. That's easy to do as well. I've used beancount for the examples on screen, but similar principles apply for ledger and hledger, just with minor variations in file format and command line. And one unquestionable advantage of doing things this way is that these tools are very easy to chain or connect to your own tools. So if you want to be doing a lot of scripting, it's as simple as hooking up the output of these tools, which is text, to the input of whatever script you write. That could be pretty powerful for some people. So let's start off by recognizing the biggest virtue of plain text bookkeeping. I think this is a great way to learn double entry accounting. Most of the plain text systems are basically implementing what in accounting software we call the general ledger module. The specific account journals exist, but are usually sort of constructed synthetically or inferred by the tools after the fact. Although most of the tools go out of their way to avoid using the terms debit and credit, the concepts are absolutely there. Using a plain text tool at small scales feels very natural. Essentially, you're taking notes on your transactions and annotating them in a straightforward way so that they can be processed systematically. The other aspect of plain text bookkeeping that I like a lot is that the community is really enthusiastic. There are multiple competing systems, but the creators and users generally are very cooperative with each other, and getting help is as simple as popping a question on a Reddit forum. Basically, it has that good vibe you get when a bunch of really enthusiastic amateurs want to evangelize a thing that they love. If you need help getting into plain text accounting, you'll have no shortage of friendly strangers eager to help you out. So, what's the fly in the ointment? If plain text accounting is so great, why didn't I keep using it? I'll break this down into three reasons. First, my financial life is comparatively complex. I describe the plain text accounting tools as simple, but there is such a thing as too simple. Accounting software isn't complicated because software developers hate you. Accounting software is complicated because accounting is complicated. I need my software to handle a large number of bank and brokerage accounts with a large number of transactions that are modeled in many different ways: accounts payable, accounts receivable, and I need a per-transaction audit trail. Beancount provides a general ledger. Yes, with enough elbow grease and custom scripting and GitHub actions, I probably could implement an accounts payable system that's auditable on top of a general ledger, but who would want to do that? And to be clear, all of the plain text accounting systems emphasize that they're for tracking your personal finances. So I don't blame them for not being purpose-built for my complex suite of use cases. It's no shame to say that a screwdriver isn't the right tool to hammer in a nail. And the main reason I set the plain text tools aside is just that. The tools were fine, but they weren't a match for my needs. Beyond that, though, the more I used BeanCount, the more I began to feel that I had philosophical disagreements about what problems are important to solve. From my point of view, even at the level of the simplest personal finances, the single biggest problem is we are human, and humans make mistakes. Double entry accounting is great at catching those mistakes, and Ledger and BeanCount will, and hledger, will definitely help you do that eventually. But saying that your primary interface to data entry is type freeform text with syntactic white space in a text editor means that there's an entire class of simple errors that can't, or rather won't, be caught immediately. For example, if I'm in GNUcache and I type a number with two decimal points, it will see right away that I've made an error and will insist that I correct that specific transaction before even allowing me to proceed. I find value in that. That type of feedback really is invaluable in preventing me from propagating the same type of error over a large number of transactions. In plain text systems, you generally only find your errors when you run the tools, sometime after saving the file. In many ways, this is a lot like the programmer's edit, test, compile cycle applied to finances. Now, there are GUIs available to sit on top of your plain text system that act more like the traditional accounting systems we're used to. But at that point, I would argue you're no longer using the systems as they were pitched to you, and instead you should just choose which GUI you like best. So the plain text bookkeeping tools are trying to maintain this invariant of plain text file and privileging solving that problem over the problem of solving and validating UI input. That's a valid choice, but it's not one that I like. And this brings up my other philosophical objection to this class of tools. What does plain text even mean? Does it just mean that the text is UTF-8 and human readable in a Unix-style text file? In actuality, all of the plain text accounting systems have fairly complicated file formats. Those formats are just invisible to the eye. Yes, they're plain text in the sense that I can open them in a text editor. But if I want to use BeanCount, I have to remember to separate the date from the payee with an asterisk, to indent all of the split lines detailing cash flows, and to have declared the accounts before using them. And if tomorrow I decide I want to switch to Ledger or hledger, I need to either write my own tool to convert the file format or hope someone else has written one and that it works. While I was doing research for this video, for example, I used someone's recommended script to convert beancount to hledger, and it worked for my simple transactions and failed dramatically for the more complicated ones. All of which is to say, sure, I can print out my ledger and read it, or pop it into a text editor and search for the word pizza, but that's not the same thing as having actual data portability. Almost any piece of accounting software will let you export the ledger to CSV, comma-separated values. Heck, you can open a QuickBooks file in Excel and export that to CSV if your copy of QuickBooks has gone missing. That's almost as plain text, in my opinion, as what BeanCount Ledger and hledger are offering. And what you buy for that is better input validation, and a database that isn't just a flat text file with all of the risks associated with that. So where does this leave you, gentle viewer, if you are considering this for your own books? Here's what I think. If you don't know a lot about double entry accounting, and you have a relatively straightforward financial life, any of hledger, ledger, or BeanCount are a great way to jump on. You'll learn a lot, you'll become more financially literate, and you might even have fun doing it. If you're doing a relatively small number of transactions per day and deal primarily with cash bank accounts, credit cards, maybe the occasional stock purchase or sale, the tools should scale to your needs just fine. If, however, you either have to deal with a large number of transactions each week, I'd say more than about 100, or if you have to structure a lot of complicated transactions, such as, for example, accruals-based payables or receivables, maybe treat these tools as a nifty hack and then reach for something more appropriate to your needs. This has been Tea Leaves Programming, counting like it's 1479. Thanks so much for watching.